In medieval times, the men were itinerant tinkers, and the women gave themselves freely to strangers who came to the village. But although Jouea is ancient, with Phoenician cisterns, its people are Metawile, who came not long ago, and the many kinds of face which I saw, Negroid, Turkish, even a pure Castilian doña, were the fruit of foreign wives brought back by emigres. I had a room by a terrace overlooking the village, and a garden where geraniums were trying to grow. On one wall hung a tapestry of Venetian ladies buying parakeets in the Piazzetta San Marco. On another, a picture of the Virgin cradling the Holy Child, for the Muslims reverence Christian figures. The old man left at dawn for the slaughterhouse, where he cut the animals at the throat, as a Muslim must, to let the blood out cleanly. And I said goodbye, while Noah turned her sad face squarely to me, thrusting a pen into my hands, and asked me to write to them. Every hill is crowned by a village, a saint's tomb, a castle, or a convent. But beyond Jouea, the country changed. The ridges drooped and darkened, and the road was blocked by soldiers, stern in helmets with camouflage nets, behind sodden heaps of sandbags. "You are entering a forbidden area." I had a 4-day military permit from Beirut, acquired with difficulty, and a letter from the Ministry of Tourism. They let me go, but looked at me, I thought, as sportsmen watch grouse out of season. A hailstorm crept over my shoulder while I was walking to the blue sky in front of me. The weather had been full of madness all month, with sleet on Easter Day, and the Beirut-Damascus road fallen in with rain. But now the castled hill of Tibnin deployed its broken turrets through the storm, and conferred with it in a drama of forbidding beauty. Raised on an ancient site against Tyre by the crusading prince Huguet de Saint-Omer, lord of Tiberias, it was first called Thubron, a high place. When he died, it passed to a family who took its name, and Honfroy II of Thubron became constable to the king in Jerusalem, Baldwin III, and commanded respect at a time when the Crusader lords were petty and changeable.